Independence reached the West Indies in the 1960s, and with it came a determination to reject the colonial past in all its forms. Here in Jamaica, there's been a campaign to make Patois, the local speech, as socially acceptable as standard English. It's all around, and no longer regarded as a badge of social inferiority.
I made to the corner with Americans!
Wicked!
Tomorrow we're going to do some fried fish party, so we have some kids tomorrow. Some people from town.
About 2 weeks after seeing jam like a couple stick in the ear, so well then it look like he's going out of it, you know?
Pull up!
Anybody who wants to communicate with the public effectively in a language of feeling and a language that will get them to move and to act uses Jamaican.
Well, here we are again, the Vibe Master, Jerry D, you don't know. I want to play some Boji Bantan, some Bob Marley, some Barry Salmon.
Obviously, it's gone into popular music. It's radio. The radio talk shows are largely carried out in Jamaican, even by people who can speak English. It is not the language of simply for illiterate, ignorant people.
Patois on the airwaves or in the dance hall is one thing. For it to be tolerated or encouraged in the schoolroom is another.
Now, if we were going to talk patois, can you think of another way in which we could say, how are you? What could you say?
How you do?
Wagwan. What else?
How you do?
How you do? What used to happen, right, is when Jamaica was under slavery, before slavery was abolished, the slaves, when they used to have to break...
There are those, like the poet and performer Joan Andrea Hutchinson, who actively promote patois among children. But it's not government policy yet to teach it in schools. Here, standard English is still the norm.
5, 6, 7, and...
And there are those who argue that children educated in patois at the expense of English would be placed at a serious disadvantage in dealing with the rest of the English-speaking world.
What would you say to that argument?
I would say a typical Anglo-Saxon response. The Anglo-Saxons seem to think that people can only speak one language, right? In fact, multilingualism, bilingualism is the norm. There's no particular reason why Jamaica will be cut off simply because Jamaicans use Jamaican, or the language that is popularly called patois, for purposes of organizing their lives internally and using English for international communication. But I think it's a mindset, an Anglo-Saxon mindset, in which English is the official language of Britain and the US, and it's also an international language, but that's an accident of history.